Hi guys, I'm glad all my friends have asked me to join you. There was a magnitude 4.7 earthquake near Wells, Nevada today at 12:21 Central Daylight Time or 10:21 a.m. Pacific Standard Time that 225 people reportedly said they felt. Here's that earthquake as it came in at Chalk Mountain, Churchill County, Nevada. That's at the top. We got here in the middle, Carver's, Nevada, and then at the bottom, let me bring it down, you can see its signature, Tapopa Springs, Nevada. Since then, it looks like there was one aftershock right here that USGS isn't reporting. You can see the signature right there. Let me bring it up for you. And the problem is there isn't any monitors that are close enough to actually record any decent aftershocks in this location. This earthquake was in an area, what they call the Great Basin, near Snake Mountain South Fault. That's that red line. It looks like to me this fault probably extends all the way down along this mountain here, which would be Signal Hill. USGS and different universities used to have quite a few monitors in this area, but they have not been maintained. Wells, Nevada, where this earthquake was close to, and Ely, Nevada. They used to have monitors, but they're no longer up and running. 95% of Nevada is in the area they call the Great Basin. Over here on the right, we have the Wasatch Fault Zone. The basin is an area of stretching. And here you can see on the moment tensor ball how we got stretching. First wave of the earthquake came straight up. Tension was applied. Oh, going northwest kind of. I want to give a shout out to Nancy. She's the one that sent me a text message about this earthquake. I didn't even see it on my phone until about 3 hours later. Yeah, I've been doing some spring cleaning in the fall, I guess you can say. Been busy doing that. Shame on me, right? Well, thank you, Nancy. Anyways, I appreciate it. We got reports all the way from Winnemucca and all the way to Salt Lake City. And then we got here Eureka, Humboldt National Forest. That's where the earthquake occurred at. And USGS gave this an intensity level of 5. The reason it was felt over such a large area, and they consider it 5 to be a moderate earthquake, light shaking, is because this area is basically filled in from sediment from the ocean, filled in from sediments from when the glaciers retreated, when the mountains built up, and eroded into this whole area. Even though the tension, most of the people that reported the earthquake was on the northwest side, I would say that pressure, most of the pressure from this fault movement of the spreading, is going towards Salt Lake City. That's just my own opinion, towards the Wasatch Fault Zone. Looking at the moment tensor ball there at the top, yeah, you can see it's on the right, and the dipping, yeah, it's mostly going towards that location. Going back to Google Earth, yeah, I've done quite a few reports about the Salt Lake area and if they have a large earthquake. Now, this area has had in the recent past, even including over here, magnitude 6. In 2008, there was a 6.0 up by Wells, just outside of Wells. But the great concern is the Great Salt Lake area. People don't realize that if they have a large earthquake, this lake would actually tip going towards the east. And I don't know if you can see this area all drawn out in blue. This would be flooded out by an earthquake raising up the ground, tipping the lake, and flooding out Salt Lake City. And that's a fairly populated area. Let's see, in 2020, there was a 5.7. That was on March 18th of last year. Yeah, we got the interstate over here where the flood line's supposed to go down to, and West Valley City, etc. So even though USGS considers this a moderate earthquake, I'm sure because of the makeup of the soil, there probably would be some hairline cracks if there's bridges going over some rivers. I hope they would go out and inspect them. It is a sparsely populated area other than Wells. People living there might want to check their foundations. Did you guys have anything fall off the shelves or off the walls? Are you earthquake prepared? Do you have your hot water heater bolted? Do you have your bookcases bolted? Do you have an emergency supply kit, a bug out kit, in case there is ever a large earthquake in this area? Like I said, there was a 6.0 not too long ago that did cause quite a bit of damage. The University of Utah has an image of some of that damage from unreinforced masonry after that earthquake. Notice the red paint and the X. I guess they checked to make sure that there was no one crushed underneath that building when the front of it collapsed, to say that it had been checked and cleared. So a big shout out to Nancy. Thank you for letting me know. But if you did have damage, and tell me what it felt like. Did your pets react before or after? Please put all that information down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.